Yo guys, welcome to RenderRam. My name is Jaco, and today I have some questions for you guys, and I would like if somebody can clear the air on what's right, what's wrong. So have you noticed that whenever you would be modeling something, you have your, you know, object, and then you have a couple of modifiers on your object, etc., and then you would collapse the object, like collapse the modifier stack. Sometimes you would end up with editable poly, but sometimes you would end up with editable mesh. Now, with that in mind, editable mesh is generally known to be, you know, viewport friendly, like the objects in editable mesh are going to be much faster in viewport, where editable poly is much more designed for modeling, etc., but it does not have, you know, the viewport performance that editable mesh has. So I started generally digging, you know, like what's the actual difference between mesh and what's the difference with poly, and I generally found out that mesh, you know, editable mesh is an old technology, but it has a very few modeling features that you can use, where editable poly is pretty much, you know, modeling on steroids injection with all the features and functionalities, meaning that with editable mesh, every vertex, every polygon has much less data in it than editable poly has. Now, also, you know, I would make a test where I would have an object that would have, I don't know, 60 million polygons, and I would see that when I was in editable poly, my RAM usage was like, I think 46 gigabytes. Sorry, I was looking at the entire Windows RAM. I forgot to look just the app, but in general, my Windows was using 46 gigabytes, but when I had that same object in editable mesh, it was 38 gigabytes. So like there is a size difference. So I generally was very curious, like, is there a scenario where I can actually purposely use editable mesh and where I can purposely use editable poly? So I generally stumbled upon this scenario. So look at this. So I got two teapots here. One is editable mesh, and the other one is editable poly. Now, I'm gonna toss Turbo Smooth on the first one, Turbo Smooth on the second one. If I right click on that Turbo Smooth and click Collapse 2, I'm gonna get editable mesh. But if I go to one that's editable poly and I right click and collapse, I'm gonna get editable mesh again. And then after some searching, it turns out that, as I mentioned previously, mesh has a better performance in viewport, right? It turns out that Turbo Smooth is pretty much designed that it outputs an object as a mesh just so that it saves RAM, viewport performance, and all that. On the other hand, if I apply mesh smooth on these two objects, let me just turn off isoline display. So mesh smooth on the other object, look at this. Mesh smooth will end up as a poly, and on my editable mesh, mesh smooth will end up as a poly again. Oh, by the way, don't forget, Pulze has a Black Friday deal, minus 25% off, valid until December 2nd. You can get all the products here at a 25% discount. I currently have a scene here where I'm using Scene Manager. I've pretty much got this whole thing set up in 3 minutes, so look at this. I can just easily change all my cameras, like choose what's happening in the scene. This shot, for example, doesn't have any props on the bed, where this one has all the props. And once I'm satisfied with the whole thing, you just press the little teapot button, and you can start rendering your project. Oh, by the way, maybe in this video, my ugly face is hidden somewhere. And I don't know, whoever finds it, you might win some sweet Pulze prize. I don't know, maybe some 3-month scene manager. God knows. See if you can find my face. Let's continue with the video. Now, if we go to the beginning of the whole conversation, where I said that poly is actually slower, but it has much larger modeling capabilities, where mesh is, you know, viewport friendly, but it doesn't have the modeling power. Now, with all that in mind, I stumbled across one scenario. Like when I was researching the whole data channel thing with Rust and all that, the video that I did previously, I was posting something on Stack, on the Facebook group Stack, and I got a comment there that pretty much said, I had like editable poly, and then I had turbo smooth, and then I had editable poly again, etc. And then I think Changsu said that that because I have, you know, editable poly, turbo smooth, and then edit poly again, I'm having a conversion tax. I don't really understand what does that mean. But now what I've shown here, turbo smooth outputs mesh, And then when you edit poly above, it converts that mesh to the polygons again. But he said that it's a conversion tax, meaning there is some performance impact going on here. And then I generally started researching the whole field, and it turns out that a lot of these modifiers, some are polygon based, some are mesh based, and some just don't care what you use. So for example, if you add a UVW map modifier, like, it doesn't matter if you have a poly or mesh below, when you collapse, it's going to be poly or mesh, whatever you have. Because look at this, if I, for example, you know, choose a modifier, let's say optimize, and I collapse the optimize, you see, I'm in editable poly here, and I collapse it, I'm going to get mesh. Now I'm thinking, the conversion tax obviously is a thing. How much does that conversion tax kind of impact the whole thing? I got no idea. I'm trying to figure that out. And now I'm like practically thinking, if conversion tax is a thing and that's a kind of bad thing, right? Would it be more smart to do this? So I got my teapot here, which is in editable poly. So let's say I need to do some extra modeling on this and I'm gonna add edit poly and I do my changes. But now I need to subdivide my model and I need to continue modeling. So I'm going to be adding open subdiv, because the same as mesh smooth, open subdiv also outputs poly. So I'm going to add open subdiv, and now I'm going to click on edit poly again, because I need to continue my modeling, and then I want to finish the whole thing with turbo smooth. Would this be more kind of a healthier arrangement of modifiers? Because look, I have editable poly, and then I have edit poly that outputs poly, open subdiv that outputs poly, edit poly that outputs poly, and then I got turbo smooth that outputs mesh. And since I mentioned a couple of times that, you know, mesh is much faster and lighter on max, you know, for viewport performances, speeds, whatever, is it true that turbo smooth is actually a finisher modifier? Like, you add turbo smooth just to close the whole deal, and then you have a very, I don't know, optimized scene or something like that. Because, you know, like, I would use turbo smooth on two different locations, but then because of that turbo smooth, it turns out that there is a conversion tax, because, you know, it goes from poly to mesh and then from mesh to poly again. And yeah, if somebody knows a little bit more about this topic, I would be happy to read it. Like, do you maybe know how does that conversion tax impact the whole thing? Like, does it make the modifier stack less stable, for example? But in general, you know, what's actually happening here? So if some of you know an info like that, please write down in the comments. And that's it for today, guys. So I don't know, I hope you're not as confused as I am. But like I said, if you know something, write down, and see you in the next video. Bye.
Just a quick note, this contest is not sponsored by YouTube. I'm solely responsible for the contest and delivering the prizes to winners. Good luck.